Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about the HubSpot API. Now, if you're looking to build an integration between HubSpot and a third-party software because maybe you need to get some data from HubSpot to that third-party software, or maybe some data from that third-party software to HubSpot, well, you're going to be using the HubSpot API for that. Now, in today's video, what we're going to go through is how you can set up a private app within your HubSpot account to have access to an access token, which will give you access to utilizing the HubSpot API. We're going to go through this entire thing in this video, and we're going to be creating a private app, setting up the scopes, and even using webhooks so you can capture real-time data within HubSpot to your integration in the sake that you're building a real-time sync between another platform. And we're going to go through all of that today, so we'll dive right in. Once you're in HubSpot, you'll see the little gear icon. Again, most times we start these videos off on the settings page, and that's exactly what we're going to do here. So we're going to dive into the settings, and we're going to go under integrations to private apps. Now, you might not see anything in here. I just have a little test one here, but you'll see this button here to create a private app. Now, private apps basically let you get access to the HubSpot account on which you're building it on and view all of the logs that API, that app is making to your HubSpot portal. So it gives you better insight as to what the integration is doing and what it has access to. So we'll go ahead and dive right in and create a private app. For this case, let's say I'm building an app between HubSpot and AMS integration. So AMS is, in the insurance world, it's an agency management system. And so this is where typically some policies are held. Let's say we want to build an integration between that. We can go ahead and create a private app. We'll put in the description into this integration sends HubSpot data to our AMS system. Then we'll go to the next step, which is the scopes. Now, the scopes basically allow you to have access to specific things within your HubSpot portal. It allows this app to have access to specific things in your portal. So you have all of the different scopes in HubSpot. For example, the CMS, if you need to integrate with the domains or if you need to integrate with the serverless functions. Now, typically, most of the scopes that you're going to need in a typical object-based integration will be under the CRM. So you might need access to read and write contacts. So we'll go ahead and do that. We also do deals. And if you need access to the schema, which is sometimes important, if you want to pull a list of all the properties in real time in this application, in this integration, then you want to enable the schemas as well. Maybe we just want to read them and not be able to write. There's some more information under settings, and then there's also some under standard, which you will find if you're working with, say, tickets. You'll see down here there's an option for tickets. It's kind of excluded from the CRM aspect. You won't see tickets in here, so that falls under standard. And so we'll go through and we've selected these scopes. You can see here we can view properties and other details about contacts. We can create, delete, and make changes to contacts. We can view properties about deals, create, delete, and make changes to deals, and view deals, view details about deals, view details about the property settings for contacts. So that's good for now, and then we'll go ahead and go to the webhooks. The webhooks basically allow your integration to receive real-time data when something specifically changes in HubSpot. So let's say you want to trigger something on another system when a deal moves pipeline stages. Well, in that case, what you can do is actually put in a webhook URL. This is the integration maybe you're going to read this data on. I would suggest, for scalable integrations, you can use something like AWS SQS and queues. And if you're using something like Google Cloud, you can use PubSub, which allows you to read messages in real time and process them and send them downstream to a function. So in this case, just to show you guys how this would work, you could create a subscription here. And let's say we wanted to listen to the deal property changed, or anytime a deal is created, maybe that's what, you know, in this case, maybe you can do that. You can select more than one. So let's say we do these two. It's still going to ask me what property. In this case, I'm going to say deal stage because I want to listen to when the deal stage changes. Then you can click subscribe, and then you'll see right now it's paused. Once you have a target URL put in here, and I would suggest you can use things like webhook.site and just pop in the webhook URL that they provide, activate this, and then change the deal stage, and you'll see on webhook.site real time the event that HubSpot sends you that will be sent to your integration, so you can process it and make changes accordingly on another system. So that's how the webhooks work. Again, real time data that you can capture on your integration on your application in real time. And so the benefit of webhooks versus something like polling, which would be every set frequency, let's say every hour we read contacts for changes, that's a little bit inefficient because you might be reading when there hasn't been any change. So the webhooks is a much more efficient way of handling integrations because it's specifically listening to what you are looking for and sending you that in real time. So we'll go ahead and create the app, and we can continue creating. And this will give us a token here that you can actually copy. And once you've created it and copied it, you'll see in here, it'll give you that application in your private apps now, and you can go to the private app, and then you can see what the API calls have been, the authorization. If you need to change scopes on here, you can click edit app, and then you can go back to scopes. And you'll be able to see if you need to delete it. You can see the access token and the client secret. This is for signature validation if you're running the integration and you need to validate the signature. Then the logs, this is going to give you a list of all of the API calls that you've made. So once you've created this, go ahead and view access token, copy it. And then what you can do is actually navigate to the HubSpot API docs, and you can go through here, and they have outlined and done a very good job on their documentation. So for example, in this case, let's say I wanted to read a deal, I could go to, you know, CRM and objects and deals under their API, and I can see what endpoints they have accessible in here. So the endpoints are basically URLs that you can get data from, send data through, and you know, I won't dive into the overview of what an API is. That's not what this video is for. But just so you know, once you've created this access token, this private app, you'll want to use that with the HubSpot API, and you can start testing your integration. So for example, let's say we wanted to read a deal, we could put in the deal ID here, and then we can go ahead and test the call by putting in our private app access token directly here. And what that'll do is actually, once you click test call here, it'll give you a response similar to this one here, which will give you a list of it'll give you the properties of that deal that you're looking for that you put in with the ID. It'll give you some basic information. If you need more information, you can use the properties and, you know, add in another one. Like, let's say I wanted to add deal stage as a property, or let's say I wanted to add a product as a property that's a custom property that maybe is on the deal. So you can use it this way, and this is how I would recommend testing out the HubSpot API. So we've gone through the basics. You know how to create a private app in HubSpot. You know how to set the scopes. use the webhooks functionality, and get your access token to then be able to use the HubSpot API and start building your integration. Now, we've worked on a lot of different integrations throughout the time, and some more complex, some less complex, but if you have any questions or need any help with integrations, please feel free to comment below. I'm happy to help you guys out. I hope you liked the video. Please thumbs up, and see you guys next time.